Hello. Welcome to the press conference at the Foreign Correspondents Club of Japan. My name is Teddy Jimbo. I'm a co-chair of the committee that's organizing the press event, including this one. And I'm your moderator today. And our speakers today are, my further right is Mr. Masahiko Yamada. Many of us might know him as a former agricultural minister under the DPJ government. And he's now working as a lawyer. And also another speaker on my immediate right is Mr. Koji Iwatsuki. He's also a lawyer. And the two gentlemen here represents a 1,063 plaintiffs who sued the Japanese government on May 15th, claiming that the TPP, the Trans-Pacific Partnership, is unconstitutional, and thus claiming injunction of the ongoing negotiation. They're here to explain why they are doing this, why they are so against this TPP treaty. And today we'll have a statement both from Mr. Yamada and Iwatsuki, both kind of short one. And then Mr. Iwatsuki is going to explain the content of the lawsuit. And then we'll have a Q&A. We have till 4 o'clock. So I'd like to get as many questions as possible. Again, we have our usual interpreter, Mr. Tamako Takamatsu, as always. And there'll be an interpretation by Ms. Takamatsu. So let's start with Mr. Yamada first. Then now we move on. Just before going into the conference, please be reminded that your cell phone is switched off or in put in the manner mode so that they will not be disturbed. If you guys are ready, let's begin. So Mr. Yamada, please.
じゃあ私から今回 TPP 違憲による差し止め訴訟を提起したいきさつについて簡単に話させていただきます。
So I'd like to begin by giving you some background information as to why we launched this lawsuit, why we want this TPP to be declared unconstitutional, and why we want to put a stop to the negotiations.
TPP 交渉を日本が交渉参加を政府が言い出してかれこれ5年近くなります。当時私は農水大臣をしておりました。で、これはもう農業と経済の問題ではなく、国の形が変わる大きな21分野にわたる問題だから大変だっていうんで、当時国会議員250名ぐらいで TPP 慎重に考える会を立ち上げました。
The TPP negotiations have been in the news for some time now. It has been about 5 years ago that Japan declared its intention to consider joining the negotiations. At the time, I was serving as the agricultural ministry, as was explained earlier, and I realized from the very beginning that this was a very, very huge matter, not only affecting the agricultural sector for which I was responsible, and not only affecting other parts of the economy, but much, much more wide encompassing, because after all, it covers some 21 sectors. As a result, I had the idea from the very beginning that this would be a very serious problem, and I gathered together about 250 Diet members, parliamentarians, and we organized a meeting, an organization, which was to consider carefully the merits and demerits of the TPP.
The 政府高官を呼んで毎週144回にわたってTPP の交渉、それの内容について問いただしました。しかしながら秘密交渉だということで、なかなか思うようなことを文書も出してもらえないし、 何を危惧しているかということについて触りだけを政府が述べる文書を出しただけで、あの秘密交渉のもと全て内容を明らかに TPP 交渉で何が日本に求められるかということが分からずに今日まで来ました。
As a result, our organization had government officials come to speak to us some 144 times. They came once a week. But because, as you know, the negotiations are confidential, they would not produce documents. There was very little that they could actually touch upon. And so even though so many years have passed, it is even for Diet members very, very difficult to understand what exactly is being asked of Japan in the TPP negotiations. This confidentiality has continued to this present day.
秘密交渉のままでこのままもしあの大筋合意とか基本調印されたら国民の生活そのもの国の形そのものが変わる大変な問題で、これは日本国憲法21条の国民の知る権利を侵害しているのではないかと3年前に隣にいる岩月浩司弁護士に相談しました。
As I mentioned earlier, this confidential negotiation has been taking place for many years now, and I am quite concerned about the fact that if things continue the way that they are, and a general agreement is arrived upon, or a fundamental signing takes place, then the changes that could be brought to the entire nation, to the daily lives of the people, could be enormous. And I believe, therefore, that this negotiation, which is going to so drastically, if it is passed,alter our everyday lives and maybe the very shape of our nation goes against Article 21 of the Constitution, which guarantees the right of the people to know access to information. Therefore, 3 years ago, I approached the gentleman to my left, Mr. Iwatsuki, and Iwatsuki, and asked him for advice.
で、まあ、日本国憲法と日本国の司法制度にはあの憲法裁判所がないんで大変当時難しいのではないかといろいろなかなかあのできないでおりました。で、はい、ところがあの1年ほど前、これはなんとか日本においてもイラク派兵訴訟とかいろんな形で憲法違反であるという判決も出てますし、なんとかこれを憲法違反による差し止め訴訟ができないものかと約1年前から弁護士、まあ、10人前後からこの約1年間にわたって今日まで勉強会を続けてきました。
However, I was told by Mr. Iwatsuki that because Japan does not have a system where there is a court that specializes in constitutional matters, it might be very, very difficult to try to find legal ways to stop the negotiations or to alter the negotiations. So for many years, we were stymied. But about a year ago, there were many, many developments in the judicial system in Japan. In other words, many cases came to court which was based around the constitutionality or unconstitutionality of various issues. For example, the dispatching of troops to Iraq would be one example. As a result, since the courts did seem more willing and there seemed to be a trend for courts to handle matters that had to do with constitutionality, we thought this might be an opportunity. So for the past year, about 10 lawyers have come together and we have conducted periodic study groups on this matter.
当初10人ほどで始めましたけども、合宿もやったりして最終的には弁護団157名、そして訴訟の会を設立して原告だけで1063名で、そういう形で あの差し止め訴訟皆さんにお配りしているものをあの先月の15日に東京地裁に出すことができました。
As I mentioned, we started off with only 10 lawyers. However, we did overnight study sessions and our numbers ballooned to a final figure of 157 lawyers. There are 157 in our group. Also, we put together enough people to actually file the lawsuit. and the plaintiffs numbered 1,063, as was mentioned earlier. And so on May 15th, last month, we did file with the Tokyo District Court this petition or complaint about the TPP negotiations.
いろいろな議論が弁護士仲間でもありました。そして原告の中からも、まあ、いろんな意見を聞きながら、最終的には私の隣にいる矢月弁護士がこれをまとめ上げて一つの訴状にすることができました。
So the actual complaint that was filed, or the petition that was filed with the Tokyo District Court, has been distributed to you. It's very, very long. It reflects the fact that there were so many different opinions, even among the different lawyers and among the different plaintiffs. And so we took all of these ideas into account. And it is really the final work of Mr. Iwatsuki sitting next to me, who took all of the different disparate ideas and put them into one long complaint or petition.
The 訴状の内容等については矢月弁護士から説明いただきたいと思っています。
So in regard to the actual contents of the suit, I would like to turn the mic over to my colleague.
訴状の内容について、簡単に説明させていただきます。
So I would like to speak very, very briefly about the contents of this petition.
端的に私たちが裁判に訴えなければならないというふうに考えたのは、TPP が日本国憲法が保障する国民の生命に対する権利、健康で文化的な生活を営む権利を侵害する、そういう結果を生むと考えたからです。
To put it very succinctly, we felt very strongly that we had to file this suit, or we had to file this petition or complaint, because the TPP was something that we regarded as something that would infringe the basic human rights, the right to live and the right to conduct a wholesome cultured life as guaranteed in the Japanese constitution of the Japanese people. In other words, it would infringe upon our these rights.
私たちは TPP は憲法の基本的人権尊重原則と相容れないと考えます。
We believe that what is guaranteed in the Constitution, the guarantee of fundamental human rights, the TPP goes against this.
TPP は貿易協定と言いながら、グローバル企業の経済活動の自由や利益を保障するために、国内の制度を非関税障壁として撤廃することを目的としています。
Although the TPP is often referred to as a trade agreement, what it truly is an agreement that will allow global companies to protect or guarantee its freedom and its ability to make profits. In order to achieve this, it will be an agreement that will basically eliminate or abolish almost all of the obstacles in various countries, which all are categorized as non-tariff barriers.
条約は法律に優位する効力がありますので、 TPP が結ばれると TPP に従って日本の国内法をグローバル企業の経済活動の自由を保障するために全面的に書き換えなければなりません。
As you know, international treaties have precedence. They are more important than domestic laws. They have a higher standing. Therefore, if Japan signs the TPP, then all of the domestic laws that currently exist will all have to be either abolished or rewritten, so that the fundamental tenet of the TPP, which is to guarantee that global corporations are able to maintain their freedom and guarantee their ability to make profits, is realized.
巨大な経済主体の活動と国民の基本的人権はしばしば対立する関係にあります。
I don't think it's any news to you that quite often when we are talking about the interests of a global organization and the fundamental human rights of the average person, quite often these two concepts clash.
このために憲法の基本的人権尊重の原則が揺るがせられ、変容させられる、そう私たちは考えました。
As a result, we believe that with the TPP, it is very, very likely that the fundamental human rights, which have been guaranteed in the Constitution, will be infringed upon, and the fundamental protection of fundamental human rights will be transformed.
第2点ですが、TPP は憲法の規定する統治機構の構造を根本的に変換してしまいます。
The second point that I would like to point out to you is that the TPP would completely alter the fundamental structure by which the nation is governed, which of course this, this governing mechanism or government structure is established by the Constitution.
TPP は国政のほぼ全部にわたるほど広範囲なものです。
In other words, the TPP is so far reaching and so all-encompassing that it would basically completely alter domestic policies and domestic laws.
それは一つの法体系と言ってもいいものです。
In fact, I could even refer to the TPP as not a trade agreement, but as a system of laws.
このために TPP を結ぶと国会は膨大な法律の改正をしなければなりません。
So as I mentioned earlier, once the TPP is adopted, the Diet would be burdened with a tremendous task of taking a huge number of laws and revising them to fit the TPP.
また将来にわたっても TPP に反する法律を制定することが禁じられます。
Not only this, in the future, if a law is, a bill is considered but goes against the principles of the TPP, the Diet would be forbidden to pass or enact such a law.
内閣が一条約を締結するだけで国会に対してこのような大きな制約を課すことは、国会は国権の最高機関であって国の唯一の立法機関であるとする憲法41条に反します。
The fact that all of this would come about because the cabinet signed a single international treaty, we believe is very, very serious indeed. In fact, Article 41 of the Constitution guarantees that the Diet will be the highest organ of state power and it will be the only or sole lawmaking organ of the state. But this treaty would go against this article.
しかも改正したり廃止したりしなければならない法律の内容が非常に不明確です。
And not only this, because of the confidentiality of the negotiations, although we already understand that a tremendous number of laws will have to be revised or perhaps abolished, we do not yet know exactly what work needs to be done, which laws are going to be directly affected.
統治機構に関する憲法違反の第2点は ISD 条項です。
There is another aspect that causes us great concern, and this again goes, this is called the ISD clause, which is the Investor State Dispute Settlement System. And this again is something that will very much shake the foundations of the governing mechanism which was established by the Constitution and which, under which Japan is run today.
ISD 条項は外国投資家に対して海外の投資家の施設法廷に日本を訴えることを認める、特別な権利を認める条項です。
The ISD clause is a very, very special clause. It will allow a foreign investor to basically take the government of Japan to court, not in Japan, but in a court of its own choosing in another country.
この条項は日本国憲法が司法は最高裁判所に属するとした76条1項に違反すると考えます。
However, we believe that this goes against Article 76, paragraph 1 of the Constitution. This paragraph says the whole judicial power of the state is vested in the Supreme Court and in such inferior courts as are established by law. We believe that by taking the ISD clause, this would violate the Constitution.
統治機構に関する第三の問題を申し上げます。
There is another problem again, which would again affect the governing mechanism or governing structure of Japan.
TPP が国民生活に極めて深刻な影響を与える条約であるにもかかわらず、国会議員ですらその内容がわからない。 という秘密交渉になっていることです。
This goes back to what I said earlier about the very extraordinary nature of the TPP negotiations, which means that everything is conducted under greatest secrecy. It is all negotiations are considered highly confidential. The fact is, although the TPP is something that will tremendously affect the everyday lives of the average citizen, even Diet members do not have access to the information.
このことは条約を国会の民主的なコントロールのもとに置くとする憲法73条3号正し書きに違反します。
Article 73, there is a proviso to item 3 of Article 73 in the Constitution, which says that the authority to approve conclusions of a treatyis given to the Diet so that the nation can be put under democratic control. This secrecy of the negotiations goes against this Article 73.
そのような TPP によって基本的人権が侵害されるということを私たちは許すことができません。
So I've given you some serious examples of how the TPP would violate or infringe upon the fundamental human rights that are guaranteed in the Constitution of Japan. As a result, we cannot allow this, this negotiation to continue.
憲法が生命を最も重要な基本的な価値としていることは言うまでもありません。
I'm sure all of you know it goes without saying that the highest value that is placed on human life in the Constitution.
しかし TPP は国民の生命、健康を具体的に侵害します。
However, the TPP negotiations, TPP agreement would very much put into danger or at risk the lives and the health of the people of Japan.
日本国民は憲法13条によって生命、自由及び幸福追求の権利が保障されています。
As you know, Article 13 of the Constitution guarantees that all citizens have a right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
さらに憲法25条によって健康で文化的な最低限度の生活を営む生存権を認められています。
Article 25 of the Constitution guarantees what is called the right to life of the people, and that means they are guaranteed the right to a minimum standard of living that has wholesomeness and culture.
多くの立法の積み重ねによって日本国民には具体的な生存権が今や保障されています。
Based on these fundamental basic principles in the Constitution, many, many other laws over time have been enacted in Japan that guarantees these fundamental rights.
TPP はこうした権利を侵害します。
These laws make more specific stipulations about the rights of the people of Japan, and the TPP would infringe upon all of these laws as well.
安定的な食料供給を受ける権利。
For example, the right of the people to be guaranteed a stable food supply.
農業従事者の農業や酪農を営むことで生活を維持する権利。
The right of people in the agricultural sector to, if they choose, make a living through farming or through dairy farming.
安全な食の提供を受ける権利。
The right of the people to have a safe food supply.
適切な医療を受ける権利。
The right of the people to receive appropriate medical care.
そして包括的には生命に対する権利が侵害されます。
And again, comprehensively, the fundamental right to life, which is guaranteed in the Constitution, would be infringed upon by the TPP.
こうした多くの生存権などの基本的人権が侵害されるにもかかわらず、日本国は秘密交渉によってその妥結を急ごうとしています。
In spite of the fact, as I've explained, in spite of the fact that so many fundamental rights, the fundamental human rights, the right to life itself, which have been guaranteed in the Constitution and various laws, will be infringed upon. In spite of this, the government continues to pursue a hasty resolution to the TPP negotiations.
深刻な被害を避けるためにも 基本的人権の最後の守り手である裁判所に対して権利救済を求めるために提訴したものです。
As we are faced with a tremendous negative impact as a result of this passing or the agreeing ratification of the TPP, we turned to the courts because it is a judicial system that is the last bastion that will guarantee the rights that are listed in the Constitution. We are turning to them to declare the TPP negotiations unconstitutional and to stop the negotiations immediately.
私からは以上です。どうもありがとうございました。
Thank you for your kind attention.
Okay, thank you very much, gentlemen. So let's go to Q&A, and as usual, please come up to the microphone and cite your affiliation and name first, and please limit to your questions, not the speech.And let's start with the working press, regular member, working press. Anyone? There's no question? Ambassador? Okay, hold on. There's no one from a regular member who wants to ask questions. Okay, go ahead.
My name is Khalil Hassan, I'm Ambassador of Bahrain. Thank you very much for coming and explaining the TPP today.
Sorry, Mr. No, Egypt, I'm sorry, your ambassador?
Bahrain.
Bahrain の, あの大使でございます。今日あのお越しいただきましてありがとうございます。
You see, I think our challenge is that we live in a global world, but our laws are local.And this is a big challenge.
今我々はあの、非常に大きなその課題に直面していると思います、つまり我々の今生きている世界というのはグローバルな世界でございますしかしながら我々の法律、といいますのは全部ローカルでございます
And that's why the huge companies are winning because they know how to use the law by the same time we don't have a governmental global law
でありますので、まああの多国間企業、大企業と今のグローバル企業というのは、まあ、いろんな、その知識を持っているためにあの、まあ、世界の競争で勝っているわけでございます。しかしながら、それに対抗するためにあの各国の政府というのは、まあ、いろんな知識とか、まあ、あの 体制というのはできていないのではないかと思います。
Globalization has advantage, but has disadvantage.
つまりグローバル化にはプラスとマイナスの面が両方あるということでございますが
Globalization made this phone cost maybe $100.
つまりグローバル化のおかげでこの、その携帯は100ドルぐらいで、まあ、買えるわけでございます
made technology cheap.
つまり本当にその入っている技術を考えますともっともっと高い値段でもあの、あってもおかしくないと思います
And I think there's a huge revolution in agriculture technologies coming
そしてまあこれは携帯技術でございますか IT 技術でございますかしかしながらその農業部門におきましても今後非常に革命的な技術というのがどんどんどんどん出てくるのではないかと思います
huge which will end result in a huge amount of agriculture product in future
それによってその農業分野の生産性が非常に飛躍的に高まるのではないかと思います
for that you are worried that many farmers they will lose their jobsin this global competition and many few companies will make a lot of money.
しかしながらお話を聞いておりますと、やっぱりあの、その TPP、などがその、まあ、締結されますと、やはりその多くの、 その農業従事者が仕事を失ってしまう、つまりそのグローバルな競争に負けてしまう、そしてあの商社というのはその、一握りの大会社だけ になってしまう。
My question is, now you want to fight these global huge companies with local laws. Do you think you will win?Or you should start thinking about global laws to know how to challenge the situation and reduce the inequality which is increasing in this world. Thank you very much.
つまりあのこんな、グローバルな企業が、まあ、非常にその勝ってる、その、今日でございますが、それに対抗するためにはその、各国の国内ローカルなその法律で戦ってるわけでございます、もしかしたら皆様あの考え方をちょっと変える、時期に なってると思いませんでしょうか。つまりこういうグローバルな企業に戦うため、あるいは対抗するためにはやっぱりそのグローバルなその法体制というのが必要だというふうに思いませんでしょうか。そういうことでないとやはりあの今どんどん拡大しておりますその格差という問題を解決できないんじゃないでしょうか。
じゃあ私から答えさせていただきます。
So I'd like to begin by responding.
農業を生産性の問題ではなく食料の問題、命を授かるものだと考えたいと思ってます。
You talked about the introduction of technologies into agriculture and raising productivity. However, I don't think the problem is that we're talking about is productivity in the agricultural sector. We're talking about securing food supplies.
食の安全、いわゆる人が安心して食べられる。例えば私は遺伝子組み換え食品については非常に疑念を持ってますが、そういったあの新しいイノベーションじゃなく、いわゆる本当に安心して生命を維持できるような食料、これは非常に大切だと思ってます。
In other words, for example, one of the things that concerns me greatly is being able to secure food supplies that we consider safe and that give us peace of mind. For example, genetically modified foods are something that I'm quite skeptical and quite anxious about. What I'm thinking about is not just simply relying on new innovations. The technology has its place, but not simply seeking new innovations, but rather making sure that people have access to food supplies that are secure and safe.
そしてローカルにとっては食料自給率、それともう一つ大事なのは各地方における地域集落、いわゆる言ってみれば環境保全、そういった問題、これがグローバリゼーションの世界になるといわゆる食料問題についてはやっていけなくなります。
And also, I believe that another aspect of this is that we need to think about local food self-sufficiency. In other words, when we look at each local area, each regional area, each village, each town, then we see that it has deeper implications, wider implications. For example, we need to talk about environmental protection, environmental conservation. These kinds of concepts do not match the world of globalization.
私はいわゆるグローバリゼーションでは解決できない、市場原理主義では解決できないもの、それは医療とか教育とか食料とか、そういう問題を大事にしなければならない。だから私としてはグローバリゼーションに対するローカリゼーションというのは非常に大切だと思っています。
I believe that there are many, many problems that cannot be solved by globalization, that cannot be solved by market fundamentalism. And these problems are having to do with the medical sector, with education, and with food supplies. And I think these are areas that directly impact our daily lives, and they should be considered to be very, very precious to us. In other words, I believe that globalization has its place, but I truly believe in localization, not globalization.
Okay, next question. Okay, go ahead. You first.
Hello, my name is Patrick Walter with the German newspaper Frankfurter Allgemeine. I'm just wondering, can you talk a little bit about the time frame? As far as I understand, TPP negotiations will be finished in, let's say, 1 or 2 or maybe 3 months. When do you expect that there might be a decision on your suit?Is this going to pursue it anyhow, and how is this going to play out in your point, from your point of view, that you have some kind of legal suit going on in Japan, but on the other hand, negotiations are going on, will be finished, it will be an international treaty, and no Japanese court is going against it, I suspect. Thank you.
はい、オーストラリアの新聞、のものでございます。どのぐらい、どういうようなそのタイムフレーム、タイムラインを考えていらっしゃるのでございますでしょうか。私の理解では、この TPP のその交渉というのは、1、2、3ヶ月後に、まあ、締結、される、まあ、交渉が終わるのではないかというふうに聞いているのでございますが、それについてどう思いますでしょうか。そしてまた今、先月、この、訴状をその、まあ、出したばっかりでございますが、その結論はいつ頃出ると思いますでしょうか。つまり一方ではその締結されたものがあって、そして、まあ、国際条約が出来上がって、しかしながらこの、訴訟がまだ続いている、まあ、どのようなことを想像していらっしゃるんでしょうか。
国際法、国家と国家の間の国際法の問題と、それから国内の法体系の問題を分けて考えてみたいと思います。
I think I'd like to respond to this by, first of all, dividing the problem into two areas. One is the area of international law, which has to do with state versus state. And then the other has to do with our domestic law system.
TPP が締結されて効力が生じた場合、国家と国家の間では約束事として効力が生じます。
If the TPP is signed and it's an international treaty that comes into effect, then this is a promise that is made between states and therefore must be kept.
しかし国内法の体系では憲法が条約より効力を有するとされていますので、TPP を実際に国内で履行しようと考えると、国内法的には無効だと、憲法に違反して無効だという事態がありえます。
However, when we look at the domestic legal system, even though international treaties have precedence over domestic laws, at the same time, the Constitution has precedence over international treaties. As a result, we believe that when the TPP violating what we consider to be fundamental basic tenets of the Constitution, if the TPP if there are attempts to implement the TPP within Japan, then we could have a decision where that would be considered unconstitutional. In other words, the Constitution would win over the treaty.
したがって裁判としては国内法的にはTPP が無効であるということを確認を求めていく、あるいはそれに基づいて損害賠償を求めていくという形で続いていきます。
In other words, as you can see from our petition or our complaint, what we are doing in what we are asking for is to have the TPP negotiation considered to be unconstitutional. And as a result, we want the TPP treaty to be considered invalid in Japan. And as a result, we would ask for compensation for our plaintiffs.
国民の立場からは政府に対して、そのような TPP を再交渉して、基本的人権の守られるようなものに変えろという要求になるのではないかというふうに考えています。
So our fundamental strategy and our hope and our goal is to stand from the point of view of the average person, the citizens of Japan, and say to the government that the TPP must be renegotiated so that the fundamental human rights guaranteed by the constitutions are not infringed upon.
国際的な交渉で国民の生活の仕組みを変えてしまうという流れに対して国民の側から国際的な枠組みを変えてもらう、変えさせるというような流れを作るということも大事ではないかというふうに考えています。
In other words, what we are talking about now is an international treaty basically coming into effect that would dramatically affect and change and transform the daily lives of the people. That is the flow of events that we are seeing occurring today. However, we believe that a reverse flow can also be imagined. In other words, the people would stand up and demand that their fundamental human rights be respected and guaranteed. And as a result, the flow would go backwards and the international framework, the treaty itself, would be altered to reflect that.
前例のない裁判なので、裁判判決がいつ出るのかということは予測がつきませんが、TPP の交渉以下にかかわらず、 この裁判自体は続いていくというふうに考えています。
Of course, this is a very, very extraordinary suit. There is no precedent. As a result, we have absolutely no idea when a verdict might be given, handed down by the court. But regardless of how the TPP negotiations progress or do not progress, we have no intention but to keep continuing with our suit.
Okay, next question. Okay, I think you raised your hand first.
エコーニュースの江藤と申します。私の質問は、場所と時間についてです。まず今回訴えられたのは、東京地裁でございますが、おそらく原告の方々日本のいろんなところにおられると思います。この中で特に東京地裁を、フォーラムとしてコートとして選ばれた理由はどこにございますでしょうか。あともう一点、タイミングについてでございます。先ほどの方の質問とややかぶってしまいますが、もうすぐ条約の締結が近づいているかもしれません。なのでもっと早くやるという選択肢もあれば、場合によってはもっと、TPP 条約の内容が明らかになってから証拠を揃えてやるというやり方もあったかもしれません。特にこのタイミングでという理由についてお願いします。あともう一つタイミングに関して申しますと、現段階では交渉内容が非常に不明確なので、こんな条約はあってはいけない、そういうことが、許せない、こういうことが、会見の趣旨だったと思います。ところが、不明確な条約の内容に対してこれが違憲だと言って、訴えるのは、内容が分からないのになぜ違憲だと言えるのかというふうな反論を膨らむ気もします。ここに対する再反論をお願いいたします。
I'm from Echo News. I have some questions about the location and timing of your suit. You filed with the Tokyo District Court. However, your plaintiffs probably come from all over Japan. Why did you choose the Tokyo District Court to file your petition? And secondly, in regard to timing, this has a little bit to do with the previous question, but it is said that the TPP is close to being agreed upon. You could have had filed this petition earlier, and there's another aspect as well. You could have filed it later because so much of the negotiations is secret. You don't know the contents. It might have been one option to see what the contents were and then pile up evidence and then have a stronger case to present to the court. Why did you choose to file now? And secondly, there would be some people that, that would say that because the negotiations are secret and the contents are not known, then how can you possibly file a suit that says that something is unconstitutional when you don't even know what theContents actually are. How would you respond?
後の方の質問に対してまずお答えしたいと思います。
So I'd like to begin with the later questions first.
内容は不明確とはいえ、一部はウィキリークス等によってリークされたものが、日本語に翻訳されたものが一部あります。
Although it is a confidential negotiation, there have been some parts of the negotiations that have been leaked via WikiLeaks and which have also been translated into Japanese.
それを見るだけでも、例えば適切な医療を受ける権利がどのように侵害されるか。いうことを想像することができます。
Just looking at the parts that have been leaked and translated into Japanese, one can judge immediately that there will be some fundamental rights that will be violated. For example, the right of citizens to be able to receive appropriate medical treatment.
それから ISD 条項については具体的な事例が世界各地から報告されていて、どのように国民の権利を侵害するかということも想像ができます。
And in regard to the ISD, the investor state dispute clause that I mentioned earlier, there have been specific cases that have already been discussed about this matter from different parts of the world. And so it is very, very easy to predict how the rights of the people will be violated as a result of this clause.
最初の方のタイミングの質問について、考えていることを申し上げます。
タイミングですか。
ロケーション
、はい、I'd like to talk more about the timing.
本来はこの問題は政治が解決すべきだというふうに私は考えていました。
I believe that this is fundamentally the kind of problem that should have been solved by politicians.
しかし、国会が全く情報がないままであるにもかかわらず、国会議員がそのことを問題にしようとしない。
But in spite of the fact that Diet members did not have any access to information about this very, very important and far-reaching treaty, in spite of this fact, very few Diet members showed any kind of discontent.
主権者の代表がそのようなことでは、国民が自ら裁判を求めざるを得ないというのがタイミングの問題の一つの考え方です。
So the people are sovereignty lies with the people, and the representatives of the people are the Diet members. But the Diet members did not respond to try to protect the people's rights. So we felt that there was no choice but for the people to stand up directly and file this suit. That's why we decided to file now.
今の日本の国会の機能の仕方を見ていると、明確になってから。というような形で裁判を起こすのではまたそれは時期遅れになりそうな気がしました。以上がタイミングの問題です。
When we look at how various matters of this nature are treated in Japan, it is that once all the facts are in place or have been disclosed and one knows the contents of everything, then you file a suit. But we felt that that would be too late for something as important and crucial as this TPP. That is why we decided to file now.
ロケーションの問題について私から補足します。
I'd like to talk about the location question.
で現在この私たち訴訟団原告の中に現職国会議員だけで8人参加しています。
In the large number of plaintiffs that we have filing this complaint, there are 8 current active Diet members.
でアメリカの国会議員はその内容を知ることができる。ただ内容を見るだけで2000ページからあるものを詳しく知ることはできないだろうとは思いますが、日本の国会議員はそれすらできません。
In the United States, Congress persons are able to look at the documents. There are something like there's about 2,000 pages of documents. However, they're not allowed to take notes or anything, so they just have to look at it and try to remember it, and that's an almost impossible task. Having said this, however, Japanese Diet members are not even allowed to look at these documents.
国会のある東京地裁で、いわゆる東京での裁判が象徴的だと思って。まず東京地裁を選びました。
So considering that the Diet itself is located in Tokyo, we felt that it was symbolic to file this first lawsuit in the Tokyo District Court.
しかしこれはローカルの問題でもあり、いずれ北海道、沖縄とかそういうローカルでも随時裁判を提起できればと思っております。
Having said this, however, I have mentioned earlier that this is a local issue and affecting people throughout the nation, so that I believe that in succession we will have many, many other lawsuits filed from Hokkaido up in the north all the way to Okinawa in the south.
Okay. Any more questions? Okay.
巡回員の本庄と申します。2点質問させていただきたい。ISDS の問題についてはですね、ヨーロッパで随分議論になっておると私は理解しておるんですが、日本でこのことをその何て言うんですかね、書いておるその新聞とか雑誌っていうのは私はほとんど見たことがないような記憶があるんですが、でこれはどうしてそういうことなのかという。そのご見解を一つお聞きしたいというのが一つですね。それからもう一つは日本のその司法では、例えば地裁レベルではこういう話をきちんと受け止めてくれるんだけども、だんだん上に上がっていくにつれてダメになってきて、最高裁でいや政治的なことは司法の判断ではなくて政府の問題でございますと言って逃げちゃうのは過去の例だと思うんですが、訴訟をやってどこまで意義があるのかなというちょっと 素朴な疑問があるんですけども、これについてのご見解を教えていただきたいと思います。
I'm an associate member. I have two questions. First of all, it has to do with the ISD clause that you mentioned earlier. I've heard that this is the topic of considerable debate in Europe. However, I don't think I've ever even seen this mentioned in Japanese newspapers and magazines. Why do you think this is so? And secondly, I understand that you filed this lawsuit, and in Japan, the district courts tend to take these matters quite seriously and give a favorable verdict. But the pattern, as you all know, is that as it goes through the system, and goes to higher courts as it is appealed, then eventually the Supreme Court will strike it down, saying that this is not a matter for the judicial system, but it is a political matter that should be dealt by the government. So what, knowing that this is the system that pretty much exists in Japan, what do you think is the significance of filing such a suit?
ISD の報道が少ないということについてまずお答えします。
I'd like to first of all respond to your first question about why there is so little mention in the media about ISD clause in Japan.
実際に弁護士に聞いても10人に1人知ってるか知っていないかぐらいの認識しか日本ではありません。
It's not just the media. If you talk to 10 lawyers, you would be fortunate if you found one who had any knowledge of this matter.
圧倒的に、マスコミでの取り上げが少なすぎるというふうに感じています。
And I suppose you could say that it's because in part because the media does not pick up on this story.
ISD は国家の政策に非常に大きな影響を与えていますので、ぜひ日本のマスコミには取り上げてほしいというふうに言うしかありません。
So, I can only respond by making appeal to the media. Please, this ISD clause will have a tremendous impact on Japanese domestic policy. Therefore, please, members of the media, write about it, investigate more about it.
それから裁判所へ訴えたということの将来的な見方についてのご質問がありました。
And then you also asked about why what we expected to get in the future, gain in the future by fighting in the courts.
ご質問の通りの裁判所の状態であるということは私たちも認識しています。
Of course, the system that you've described about Japanese courts, district courts making one decision and it being overturned in the higher courts, we understand the system, of course, very well.
しかし、国民の立場から問いかける場が今裁判所しか私たちには思い浮かばないということも事実です。
But when we wanted to make an appeal from the point of view of the average citizen, at present we could think of no other venue or no other place or no other organization or system in which we could make this appeal except the judicial system.
少なくとも裁判所は理屈、論理で考える場所だということを信じたいと思ってます。
We believe and we strongly hope that courts will is a place. The courts are a place where matters are dealt with in a very logical and based on facts approach.
それから TPP あるいは貿易協定自体を憲法上の観点から考えるという裁判、問うという裁判。はおそらく初めてのものではないかと思っています。
And I think I touched upon this briefly earlier, but I think this is the first lawsuit of its kind, a suit that talks about the constitutionality of a trade agreement.
そういう問いかけを広く世界へ発信することによって、世界の国民と連帯して、この問題をに取り組んでいく。いうきっかけにできればということも考えているのが正直なところです。
And because this is such a unique suit, we hope that this will be an opportunity for us to gain more attention from people throughout the world. Because this is the kinds of problems that I've described earlier apply not only to Japan, but to people throughout the world. If this lawsuit serves as an impetus for us to be able to link hands with like-minded people in other nations, that would be something that we would very strongly desire.
司法の状況が良くないことは事実ですが、何かをやり続けていれば何か変わる時がある。 波紋が広がることがあるということを信じてやっていくというふうに考えています。
We of course know firsthand how difficult the situation is in terms of the judicial system in Japan. However, we strongly at the same time believe, fundamentally believe, and hope that if one continues to pursue something that they truly believe in and continues to keep trying, then eventually that will lead to a greater wave that will eventually transform the situation.
Okay, we are almost running out of time, but I guess we can just squeeze in one more question. Is there anyone who hasn't asked a question? Okay, I think you'll be the one.
Hello, Nicholas Smith, strategist for CSA. Doesn't it trouble you that you're making life extraordinarily hard for the common man? Doesn't it seem a problem that Japanese food prices are at astronomical levels already, with the price of rice protected by a 755% import tariff, and that the prices are likely to go up, bearing in mind that the percentage of farmers who are over the age of 70 is already 50%. So it's already going to have rising labour costs. So you're going to drive up the prices for people. And as it is at the moment, because of incompetent government moves in the 1960s, you have a calorific self-sufficiency rate of only 40% at the moment. So surely the best thing to do would be to open up the market to international competition and let the poor struggling housewife get cheaper food from overseas when they can do this more efficiently.
CSA のストラテジストでございます。今お話を聞いておりますと、こういう質問をしたくなるんでございますが、一般の日本人の苦しい生活をもっと苦しくさせているんではないんでしょうか。つまりその日本 の, その食料品の価格は非常にもうその天文学的な価格、非常に高いわけでございます。まあ、それはやっぱりその関税、例えばそのお米の関税 755% と言いましたんでしょうか。自主生ということでしょうか。もう非常に高いものでございます。そしてまた70歳以上 の, その農家がもう5割以上になっているということでございますので、まあ、賃金コストがますます今後上昇するだろうということでございます。まあ、これはいろんなその背景があるわけでございます。一つはその政府 の,、まあ、無能な政策が1960年代にあったからというのもあるわけでございますが、その食品自給率というお話でございますが、そのカロリーベースで申し上げますと、もうすでに40% ぐらい、40% 切ってる、という、ことではないかと思います。やはりその、一般の主婦が非常にその、高いその食料品、価格に悩まされているわけでございますので、一刻でも早く市場を開放して、世界中 の, その、より安価なその食料品を手に取れる方が、彼女たちの生活を楽にするのではないでしょうか。
一般に日本ではそのように思われてますが、実際に米の関税も実際には自由に貿易して入れる部分もかなりありますんで、実際の関税は 200% ぐらいなんです。 で実際に各 OECD の統計でも、日本の食料の関税っていうのは各国に比べてアメリカ、オーストラリアに次いで本当は安くなってます。
So I certainly understand what you were saying, and I think many Japanese, average Japanese, share your understanding of high food prices. However, in terms of rice tariffs, there are many. There's a certain amount, a large amount of rice that is imported free of taxes. So the actual rate of tariffs is something closer to 200%. And if we look at different data provided by OECD nations, we see that the actual food prices are actually quite lower than, for example, countries such as the United States and Australia. They are coming down.
で、確かにご指摘のように政府の無能な政策にこれまで寄ってきて、そして農業人口の高齢者を招いてきました。
But certainly I do agree with what you have said earlier about incompetent government policies in the past. That has been one of the main reasons that why the agricultural population has grown so old in recent years.
で、私が農水大臣の時にヨーロッパとかアメリカの一部でやってるように、農家に対する直接支払いの所得保障を実現いたしました。
When I myself served as the agricultural minister, I incorporated new policies that mimicked the ones that were in place in the United States and Europe. In other words, to give household guaranteed household income to different farming households.
それまでの農業土木をやめて農家に直接支払いしましたら、農家所得はたった1年で 17% 上がりました。
In other words, instead of using different intermediaries, we paid these, this income directly to the farmers, and as a result, over one year, the average income of farming households rose 17%.
そして若い人が農家に戻ってきたのです。
And as a result, this allowed many young people to enter and or return to the farming agricultural business.
農業政策次第、国内の農業政策次第で、どのように安全で安心な農作物を食料自給率を達成することは可能だと思っています。
In other words, based on my own experiences, I believe that everything depends on agricultural policy. If agricultural policy in Japan is handled wisely, then we will be able to have food self-sufficiency, higher food self-sufficiency, and food supplies that are safe and give peace of mind.
Okay, thank you very much. I think we're just running out of time. So it's going to end the press conference. And again, I'd like to give a big thank you to Mr. Yamada and Mr. Iwatsuki. Please give big hands.
どうもありがとうございました。